Hi, I'm Britt with Garmin's product support team. I want to tell you about some exciting changes available with the latest software update for your Garmin Outdoor Multisport watch. This video is broken up into three chapters, which cover additions for each product line, including our Fenix 7, Fenix 6, Instinct 2 series, and summer products. Use the timeline below or the chapters to move ahead for specifics on your Garmin watch. The first chapter will cover the latest software update for your Enduro 2, Epix Gen 2, Fenix 7, Mark Gen 2, or Tactics 7 series multi-sport watch. Before we get started, feel free to check the links in the description to learn more or to set up these features. You'll automatically receive this update if your watch is paired to the Garmin Connect application or if you have enabled Wi-Fi sync. The first section we'll cover is watch user interface changes. This includes improvements to the sunrise and sunset widget. These improvements will allow you to see the sun's position relative to your own, overlaid on the map. Being able to know the sun's position can be helpful when preparing camp near dusk or knowing when the first light of dawn will approach, as the sun's position can vary based on terrain and time of year. Next, we're covering the new training and health additions. We'll start with PhysioTrueUp improvements. PhysioTrueUp will now sync training features including HRV status, training load, load focus, and more. This can be helpful for users that utilize additional Garmin devices, such as an Edge cycling computer. In addition, for users with more than one Garmin device, they can now designate their primary training device, which will be considered the main source when syncing data. Now let's talk about Jetlag Advisor. The Jetlag Advisor provides guidance for reducing jet lag before, during, and after your trip. Use the Garmin Connect app or your watch's widget glance for recommendations on when to seek or avoid light, when to sleep, and when to be active to help recover from your trip. The last section we'll discuss includes activity updates. This includes backcountry ski and backcountry snowboard improvements. With the latest update, you'll no longer need to input your ascent or descent. Instead, the watch will automatically mark the splits for your climbs and descents. This improvement makes it easier when using gloves or ski poles. The next activity and app additions we'll discuss are wake sports. You'll now be able to add water ski, wakeboard, wake surf, and tube activities to your watch's activity list. While using these activities, the watch will detect when you're either on a run or waiting for the boat. Now let's look at Cell Expedition. The new Cell Expedition activity will allow you to record a multiple day water activity. When started, the activity will disable sensors and accessories, along with recording GPS track points in a longer time duration to conserve battery life. This feature is most helpful for adventure rowers and sailors. The last app addition is support for Outdoor Maps Plus. With Outdoor Maps Plus subscription, you'll be able to access a wide variety of premium mapping content that is regularly updated and delivered directly to your compatible Garmin device via Wi-Fi connectivity. This premium map data is collected from multiple sources, providing full coverage of all 50 US states. The full collection contains premium elevation contours as well as landowner names and boundaries for public and private land types and boundaries. This includes the Bureau of Land Management, National Wildlife Refuge, national parks, state parks, wildlife management areas, and more. See our Purchasing Outdoor Maps Plus video to get started. The next chapter we'll discuss is the latest software update for your Enduro, Fenix 6, and Mark Series multi-sport watch. Before we get started, feel free to check the links in the description to learn more or to set up these features. You'll automatically receive this update if your watch is paired to the Garmin Connect application or if you have enabled Wi-Fi sync. First, we're covering the new training and health addition, PhysioTrueUp improvements. PhysioTrueUp will now sync training features including HRV status, training load, load focus, and more. This can be helpful for users that utilize additional Garmin devices, such as an Edge cycling computer. In addition, for users with more than one Garmin device, they can now designate their primary training device, which will be considered the main source when syncing data. The last section we'll discuss includes activity updates. This includes backcountry ski and backcountry snowboard improvements. With the latest update, you'll no longer need to input your ascent or descent. Instead, the watch will automatically mark the splits for your climbs and descents. This improvement makes it easier when using gloves or ski poles. The last chapter we'll discuss is the latest software update for your Instinct 2 and Instinct Crossover Series multi-sport watch. Before we get started, feel free to check the links in the description to learn more or to set up these features. You'll automatically receive this update if your watch is paired to the Garmin Connect application or if you have enabled Wi-Fi sync. First, we're covering the new training and health addition, PhysioTrueUp improvements. PhysioTrueUp will now sync training features including HRV status, training status, training load, load focus, and more. This can be helpful for users that utilize additional Garmin devices, such as an Edge cycling computer. Now let's talk about daily suggested workout improvements. Your daily suggested workouts are now better aligned with your performance. When you either add a run or cycling event to Garmin Connect, your daily suggested workouts will adjust to help you prepare for your next event. This includes not providing a workout suggestion on event day and lighter workouts or rest days leading up to the big day. The last section we'll cover is activity updates. Let's start by talking about wrist-based run power. Run power is used to provide a reliable way to measure the actual exercise load for your activity. You'll be prompted to add the running power data screen when you begin your next run activity. By default, the new running power data source will be set to smart mode. Smart mode will automatically switch between using wrist-based heart rate and the heart rate strap when detected. While you're no longer required to wear a heart rate monitor strap, having the additional sensor will provide improved accuracy and has a faster response to changes to effort. Let's now talk about gray adjusted pace. You can now view gray adjusted pace during your run activity. This is a running data field that will provide an estimate frequency equivalent for your current pace at grade. This is an average pace adjusted by the steepness of the grade and is a better way to understand pacing over varying terrain. The last section we'll discuss includes activity updates. This includes backcountry ski and backcountry snowboard improvements. With the latest update, you'll no longer need to input your ascent or descent. Instead, the watch will automatically mark the splits for your climbs and descents. This improvement makes it easier when using gloves or ski poles. Thanks for taking the time to learn about what's new in the latest software update for your Garmin Outdoor Multisport watch. To learn more about your product, be sure to check out the links in the description or visit us at support.garmin.com.